Welcome back! Welcome back! Welcome back! Oh my god!
It's been too long!
It's been way too long. I apologize. That's on me. But welcome back. Welcome back to Sellout Club. It is not St. Patrick's Day, but it's the St. Patrick's Day special, baby!
Are you wearing your green?
I'm wearing green camouflage. Does that count?
It's green.
You know what? And just like the leprechaun on St. Patrick's Day morning, Tyler and I are both gonna sneak up to your window. We're gonna pop it open. We're gonna lean over your bed. We're gonna plant a little smooch, just a little, on your head and whisper into your ear.
God is dead.
Whoa. That got real dark real quick. But you know what? I'm all for it.
You're all for it? Did you appreciate the voice at least?
Well, of course. You gotta appreciate every little bit of effort to go into a joke.
Thank you. So, what have we been up to these past couple months, Tyler?
Oh, large amounts of living and thriving.
Oh, yeah. You know, important update. In the time span that we've been gone, we both turned 21.
Yeah, that's also true.
Yeah, we're drinking. It's the St. Patrick's Day special. We can't do that not drunk. So, yeah. Cheers.
Clink.
Clink.
What's your go-to drink of choice?
My go-to drink of choice when I'm at a bar is normally, I like mules a lot. I like Moscow mules. Normally I take, this is going to sound stupid, but normally I get like a hard lemonade or something that I'm really familiar with and then look at the rest of like what they got and decide what looks good.
Mm-hmm.
But my drink of choice, if I'm ever, like, stuck and I'm like, I want a cocktail, is probably either a Moscow Mule or an Old Fashioned. What about you? What's your drink of choice, Tyler?
Whiskey.
Whiskey?
Mm-hmm.
Just...
And finding random things to put it with.
Pro tip, just pour it in water. Do half and half. Because what will happen is that you'll be hydrating yourself and also drinking at the same time. Might not taste that good. I'd recommend doing it with something like vodka more than that, I suppose. But it works. Look at us out here talking about drinking hacks.
One thing that I have realized after turning 21 is I do not know how to take a shot.
You really don't.
I don't know how to do it. I can't do it.
So, for context, a bunch of us went out for Tyler's birthday on the 5th of March. It was a very good time. I had a lot of fun. And it seemed like you had a lot of fun, Tyler.
Well, of course I did.
Okay, good. And at the beginning of the night, our friend Trey bought, what was it first? Crown? Vanilla Crown?
Yes.
Okay. Bought a shot of Vanilla Crown. You didn't seem too excuse me. I got the burpees. You didn't seem too displeased with the Crown. It was nasty looking.
It was nasty looking, but I knew what I was getting into because I've had that before.
Okay. And then... what was the next shot? It wasn't, we had one more thing before we had the Rumplemints, correct?
I don't know.
Or did we, no, because, never mind, because we both got drinks. We both got mixed drinks.
And yeah. Then,
okay. So yeah, after that, we both had a couple of mixed drinks. And then our friend Trey, again, bought shots. And this time it was Rumplemints liqueur.
That is the most disgusting thing I've ever had in my life.
Oh, but it's cheap. You know, that's the whole point of buying shots of it. It's cheap.
It was like drinking Listerine, but as if the Listerine was kind of like night.
Kind of like what?
Like you get the consistency of NyQuil,
Okay.
but make it Listerine flavored, and that's what that was.
Your face when you took that shot, you puffed up like a blowfish. And I remember even like everybody was saying, just swallow it, just swallow it, it's gonna get worse. And even like the bartender, who looked like Daniel but was not Daniel,
I was swallowing it, but because I don't know how to swallow that much amount of liquid at one time, it was coming as more than one time. So every time I'm swallowing, there's still more stuff to go down, which too much stuff in my mouth, and I couldn't handle it anymore. I didn't throw up. Everyone seemed to think I went to go throw up, but I didn't throw up. I just went and spat it out.
No, we knew you spat it out because that's what you told us you did. Or at least I knew that. I don't know if Trey and Jaden did. But then you had, how was your next shot? I believe it was a buttery nipple.
That one was really good. It was like a mild, like a, it was like as if you had put chocolate milk with a little bit of alcohol in it.
Like that chocolate wine.
What is it called? Kahlua, I
Oh,
think. Kind of like,
yep, Kahlua. It's coffee liquor.
kind of like that.
Yep. Okay. Excuse me. I have never had a buttery nipple, but it looked very good. It looked very rich when you were drinking it.
It was a lot of flavor.
A lot of flavor.
Yeah. And I'm all about drinks with flavor.
Yeah. Yeah, and I hate the stigma of like dudes drink like beer and hard liquor. It's like, but those things taste gross. It's like
I have,
beer.
okay, and out of all of my experience of drinking, which is not very much, almost all beer is disgusting.
Almost
There's
all.
only one that I'm okay with drinking.
And what is that?
The Strawberry Natural Lights.
Okay. It's flavored beer, but it's beer, so we'll count it. I'm not a super beer guy. Beer is gross, but for some reason I do get a hankering for a Guinness every once in a while. So yeah, there's that. Other than that though, beer is kind of nasty. Hard liquor is nasty unless it's with stuff.
Yeah, I'm not gonna just walk out of nowhere and start drinking whiskey from the bottle.
See, I will, but I'm
Handle
not going to
that.
enjoy it.
Shot was like already at the brink of my limit for hard liquor straight.
Yeah.
Like if I would have had any more right after that one, yeah, I would have instantly started throwing up.
Oh. Well, next time we know we won't buy you shots. No more shots.
Either that or I just need to train myself to actually know how to take shots.
Well, you're 21 now. You can buy as much hard liquor as you want.
I'd practice with water first.
Yeah.
Water shots. That's cool.
The easiest thing I can tell you about shots is to open the back of your mouth as wide as you can when you're taking it, and then swallow. Just swallow everything that comes down. If you have to swallow it in two sittings, that's fine. But just get as
Any more
much.
than that, it's gonna hurt.
Yeah.
As I have now found out.
Well, and I believe the reason Trey bought you Rumplemints is because he was kind of like fucking with you a little bit, and not in a mean way. I think he was like, "All right, this boy doesn't know how to take shots. We got to get him to take this." Which probably wasn't the best idea, because Rumplemints is nasty. Like you said, it tastes like Listerine.
Yeah.
Like I said, I don't think he was doing it to be mean. I think he was just like, ha ha, let's get him to try this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I mean, Trey works at a brewery, so he already knows a lot about alcohol.
Oh, does he work at the Sarah's River Brewery?
Yeah.
Very cool. Good for him. Very, very cool. Let me see something here.
Doing as large amount of time has passed.
What's that?
What have you been doing in this large amount of time that's passed?
Not a whole lot. Going to school, working. I lost a car.
Me too.
Yeah, I've lost a car in this time. My girlfriend also lost a car in this time. but with the third round of stimulus payments going out, I should be able to get a car. Hopefully, probably at the end of this week, if we get it in time.
That'll be a nice check.
Mm-hmm. Be $1,400. Yep. Oh, and I was gonna ask you this the other day. Your stimulus payment. Are you aware of how that works?
What do you mean?
It's not going to be sent directly to you.
What do you mean by that?
It's going to be sent to whoever claims you as a dependent with their stimulus.
Oh, yeah, I did know that.
Yep. So it's going to be sent to, like, probably your dad?
My grandparents, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
They claim me on taxes, so then my ex-stepmother doesn't get the money from my parents' divorce.
Big brain. Big brain move.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool, though. Because Sarah's a bitch.
Absolutely.
Oh, there's been a lot of new Star Wars announcements since the last time we got together.
Oh my, yeah, yes there has. Holy cow, has it really been that long?
It has been that long. The last episode we recorded was at the beginning of November.
Let me think. The last episode, isn't it the Pixar one?
Yes, it was.
Very quality episode.
It was a very quality episode. That was a good episode. I actually really liked that episode. And part of me today wanted to do a tier list, but it's the St. Patrick's Day special, so we should probably just do, like, a regular return episode, and then, like, a tier list episode as its own thing. But at some point, I would like to go through with you, and rank on a tier list all of the bad JoJo's Bizarre Adventure localized English names. Because they're a fucking trip, man.
Yet to watch it for the first time? I mean, I could probably watch it this week.
Oh, you don't need to... You shouldn't need to watch the anime. We'll just talk about, like, I'll tell you this guy's name and show you, like, a picture of him. And then we'll talk about, like, what the English translation team turned it into when they localized it. But if you want, go ahead. It's a fantastic show. There's a lot of episodes, though.
Okay.
Yep. But yeah, some of the highlights include so the reason a lot of them are localized differently is because that they're the names of bands, songs, and albums, and singers. So, like, artists like AC/DC. There's a person in JoJo named after AC/DC. There's a stand ability called Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap, which is a song by AC/DC. And one of the absolute highlights of my experience reading JoJo over the past couple of months has been the translation the English translation in part 7 of Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap to Terrible Acts at a Reasonable Price. I love that.
I suppose because they can't for copyright, they probably can't say it.
But like, it's the stupidest sounding shit ever. Terrible acts at a reasonable price. It sounds like you're advertising something. Come on down to Terry's Murder Shack, where we got terrible acts at a reasonable price. One of the other highlights is changing the stand name Killer Queen, which is named after the Queen song, into Deadly Queen. Which, it's just so much less menacing. Because for some reason, when you see Killer Queen in the show, you'll, like, understand it a little better. But Killer Queen is a presence. And when he just pops up and the guy's name is like, my stand, Deadly Queen. You're like, okay, yeah, it takes a lot of the impact away.
Yes.
There's changing the stand Babyface to Babyhead. But yeah, well, maybe we'll do that sometime. I don't know. But Star Wars announcements. What? Let me grab my pone and look at what. When was all that stuff announced? New Star Wars.
The new Clone Wars season.
All of it. Here we go. All right, so let's see where we go. All right. Oh, no. I will just want the Star Wars stuff, not all of the announcements. Here we go. Lucasfilm.
I got it.
All right, so we're starting off with the live action stuff, or not the live action, but the standalone Star Wars stuff. Ahsoka. Ahsoka's getting her own show.
It's gonna be a good show.
I bet it will. I'm drawing a blank. Who's the lady that plays Ahsoka?
Rosario Dawson.
Thank you, Rosario Dawson. She does a really good job at playing Ahsoka in live action.
She really did.
She was a really good Ahsoka. She was really badass in the new Mandalorian season. I gotta give her that.
Mm-hmm.
Rangers of the New Republic. That is like the,
that one's gonna be good.
That looks like the Rogue Squadron's show, kind of show coming out, right?
Rogue Squadron's gonna get their own show.
What's Rangers of the New Republic then?
Isn't it kind of like I saw a thing on it. Let's have a look, see. I know this. It's supposed to be a crossover event of The Mandalorian, The Book of Boba Fett, and Ahsoka.
Okay. So The Book of Boba Fett is its own thing. Okay.
Yes.
Very cool.
Which means Boba Fett will have his own TV show.
Boba Fett's getting his own TV show. Obi-Wan's getting his own TV show. Ahsoka's.
Obi-Wan's the closest one to coming out. It's.
Yeah.
They're release it.
They're what? Sorry.
They're ready to release it. It was supposed to release in January.
Wait, really? That could be cool. I gotta pay for Disney then.
Well, it's not. They haven't released it yet.
Oh, lame. I thought they were like...
supposed to.
Have they been advertising it at all? Tyler.
Supposed to...
Oh.
be about the rebel spy Cassian Andor from Rogue One.
That'd be a good one.
Did you get what I said?
I heard Cassian Andor from Rogue One. I'm sorry. That's all I heard on my end. Here, let me. I'm losing you. I can't hear you. Let me see. Disable. Give me just a sec, bud. I'm gonna. Hello? Hello? I can't hear you. Oh, hello? Hi.
Lost ya.
I lost you. Sorry.
Okay, so Andor, that's gonna be about Cassian Andor from Rogue One.
Ooh.
The Acolyte? That'll be a Sith movie. That one will be a good movie.
The Acolyte.
Yeah.
Okay. Do we know who is the Acolyte? Or is it just like, oh, it's a Sith movie?
I know it's just a Sith movie.
Okay.
Star Wars The Bad Batch?
The Bad Batch. Almost the highlight of the newest season of the Clone Wars, and it was the first episode.
Yeah, and they were good.
They were really, really fun. They felt a lot like Delta Squad. Yeah, from the old Republic Commandos game.
Yeah.
I feel like they were definitely inspired by Delta Squad.
But they were, I believe that, and then they were based off of the Clone Trooper 99.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And then next one is Star Wars Visions.
This is the one that I'm super excited for. This is the one, it's an anthology series where they're inviting lots and lots of different animation guest directors to do, basically, long story short, Star Wars anime with lots of different, every episode is different. And it looks so cool. Or it sounds so cool. They haven't released a whole lot about it yet. But it seems really, really interesting.
A droid story about R2-D2 and C-3PO.
That sounds fun. I wonder what it's gonna be.
Me too.
I'm thinking it's, because either it's gonna be terribly dark and sad, or it's gonna be like, oh, it's like a cute little heartwarming story.
Maybe. And then one more that they have on the list is one called Willow.
Yeah, I've seen the name.
I don't,
like,
that one,
card.
That one is not really, it's not Star Wars, I mean, it's kind of Star Wars related because it's made by Lucasfilm,
yeah.
But it's not Star Wars related at all, other than the fact that there's a lot of Star Wars actors that are going to be in it, but it's not Star Wars related.
It's not.
Like, final implement of the Indiana Jones films.
Really? So that's the last.
Yeah.
That's Indiana Jones 5.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Very, very cool. I didn't know that Indiana Jones 5 was officially announced. I know that they've been working on it for a long time. What do you think about some of these Star Wars series, Tyler?
I'm ready for all of them.
Which one are you most hyped for? I'm assuming...
The Acolyte.
The Acolyte? Okay.
Yeah.
I was going to say, I'm assuming either Boba Fett or Obi-Wan. But the Acolyte? Why are you excited for the Acolyte?
The Acolyte. Because it's going to be focusing on something that they've barely even touched in any of the films and TV shows.
Which is like the Sith side of the battles, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. How do you feel about the fact that they might change potentially literally everything about Sith lore that has been known up to this point? Does that make you...
I mean, already done it, so I'm sure they'll do it again.
I mean, that's true. But, like, specifically, like, the older Sith lore. Like, obviously, they're like, oh, that stuff's not canon. But, like, a lot of people are like, well, yeah, but there's no other lore. So we're just going to be like, well, this is what happened. But now they're releasing their own thing for it. And what if they're, like, specifically, like, the Old Republic wasn't real?
That wouldn't make any sense.
Or something along that line. That doesn't necessarily what I was talking. Or, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
An earth-shattering, like what the fuck? Like, no. Or like, Darth Revan was a woman. I mean, technically Darth Revan can
do something like that.
Or they're just like, you know what? Jedis can't marry women because they're all gay and they have sex with each other.
That wouldn't make any sense either.
I'm just trying to say funny shit. Yes, because the Jedi religion abstains from desires, correct?
Yeah.
Attachment. But I mean, you can fuck without attachment. That doesn't denote detachment.
Yeah, you can't. You can try.
It's just, hey, listen. This is just shooting your goo, man. It's just shooting your goo. There's nothing attached to it.
Can you imagine just thinking if Yoda would do something like that?
Oh my god. My headcanon for Yoda is so fucked. Because, like, all of the memes and shit are how I experience Yoda now. Like, I saw a video on TikTok the other day. Like, an animated parody where Yoda, like, picked up a rock and was talking about something. And just dropped I'm talking a rock bigger than his body. And, like, he's got, like, an absurdly huge set of balls and a wang sticking out on, like, this other rock, and he just drops the big rock on top of him. And, like, all the ketamine jokes and everything, my headcanon for Yoda is just so beyond screwed up at this point. So, I'm ready to believe anything. That was a lot. I'm sorry.
Imagine, like, Yoda going to town on someone. I want to know how that would work. Because he's just so little.
I don't know, man. What if, wait. What if he has to use a quote-unquote a marital aid?
What's a marital aid?
A sex toy.
I don't know.
What if... Does Yoda have a penis? Does Yoda have a penis?
I would assume so. Since he's a male, but I mean, he's also an alien race, so I don't know.
I was about to say, what if...
He's an alien race that nobody knows anything about, so...
Exactly. What if to mate, they're just like, I'm gonna spit in your mouth, and then you're gonna be pregnant. Oh, pregnant. Like, what if he doesn't have genitals? I don't know if you're talking. I can't hear you. I'm sorry. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Me?
A little bit. I can hear you flickering a little bit sometimes.
Maybe it's just a bad connection.
I heard that pretty full. I heard one flicker during that sentence.
I did was move my microphone closer to my mouth.
I don't know. It's a mystery.
It is a mystery indeed.
Just like the mystery of, does Yoda have genitals? What if they have opposite genitals? What if the males of the Yoda race are the ones that get pregnant?
What if species are like praying mantises, where once they do the dirty with the female eats their heads?
That's the real reason Yoda died. No, it's not. He was sick.
He was 900 years old. He needed to die.
You think he had any babies? You think Grogu was his baby?
Did you watch all The Mandalorian?
No, I have not. Please.
I was going to say, because they would answer that question for you if you'd seen it all.
Okay, I'm almost done with it. I'm on episode 6.
Of what season?
2. Season 2.
They explain it in season 3.
There's a third season already?
There's 3.
What in the fuck? Okay. Okay.
Right? Yeah. How many seasons are there? Is there 3? Let me check. Pretty sure there's 3.
I thought there was... I guess I haven't watched it for a while. It's been a couple of months. But I do remember where I'm at.
Oh, I guess there's 2 seasons. Okay.
Okay, I was gonna say, like, what the fuck? That's new.
But they do explain it in the second season.
Okay, at the end.
Yeah, more towards the end.
All right. I'll be patient. What's one Star Wars character? Any Star Wars character at all that you get to choose one Star Wars character that gets to make it somehow into the next movie. Who is it?
Good question.
It can be a character from the books, the comics, a game, like any Star Wars character ever.
Galen Merrick or Starkiller?
Galen Merrick would be a cool one, and Starkiller would be really cool, but I don't... They'd have to, like, rewrite The Force Unleashed, correct? Because is he not... I suppose he's a clone.
Yeah.
So he's not... He can't be dead, because they can just clone him again, but...
It would also depend on when they set the film.
That's true. Old Man Starkiller.
He wouldn't be as powerful as young Starkiller, though.
But just imagine. Just imagine if he's, like, 3/4 as powerful as young Starkiller. And you get to see that on screen.
That'd be so cool.
Wouldn't it? Even if he's not as strong. Even if he's not, like, vaporizing stormtroopers in one hit. Like,
and it'd be really nice to finally see the voice of Darth Maul. Finally, in a live-action film.
Who plays the voice of Darth Maul? I can't hear you, I'm sorry. Hello? Well, sitting all alone by myself. It was great. Can you hear me? I'm sorry. I don't know what's going on. No. Discord. Hello? I don't see your little ring turning green when you talk. So maybe that's...
Oh.
Hello? I saw your ring turn green and I heard, oh. Hello? 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 Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
And we're finally back.
We're finally back. What happened? Did something happen on your end?
No, I haven't even moved.
I was going to say, because I see that you must have been talking, but your ring on Discord wasn't lighting up. Something must be going on with our connection.
But is it ringing up now? Oh, yeah, it is. I see it.
Yeah, because I see I have 3 bars on Discord, the full little connection thing. So I don't know.
Where does it say that?
Over bottom left corner, it says voice connected. You have.
Oh, I've got 3 bars.
I was gonna say
I've got 3 bars.
You have awesome internet, so I don't know. It must be me because I'm running it off my phone because our internet is shit.
Maybe.
And I
get I'm well aware.
Yeah, and I get 1 bar on regular Discord if I run it through my internet, my Wi-Fi. So if I use the Wi-Fi. We were talking about Star Wars.
We're talking about
the voice of Darth Maul.
Yeah, it'd be really nice to finally see him on live action screen.
Who is the voice of Darth Maul?
Okay, so you know what Starkiller looks like?
Yes.
He looks exactly like that because that's the same you know how they did the what's his name in that new Star Wars video game that they just made. I can't remember the name of it for some reason off the top of my head.
Yeah, they motion captured
Fallen Order.
Yeah.
Yeah, they did it. They did that with
Dark. Oh, really? Now, did they do that in Solo as well? Because I know Darth Maul appears at the very end of Solo.
No, that's a different person.
Okay. He doesn't do as good a job, I think. He's not quite as intimidating. I think Darth Maul is like this presence. Not unlike Darth Vader, but less so.
If you want to see how close it is, just go on your phone right now and search Starkiller actor.
Okay, give me a sec.
We have the extremely close resemblance.
Okay, give me a minute. I got my iPad. Starkiller actor. Starkiller. Oh wow, I can see it. Samuel Stewart Witwer.
And that's the voice of Darth Maul in the Clone Wars.
Okay. He also played Emperor Palpatine in Force Unleashed.
Sense.
Technically, he is a dark Jedi.
Ooh.
Ooh. Which, I mean, makes sense because
he was technically raised as a Sith.
Raised as a simp. I mean. Is Starkiller a simp? Is he a simp for Juno? Yeah?
Yeah, he is.
Alright. Confirmed.
That's the whole point of the
second one.
Blah, blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah. Starkiller is a simp.
You know what? We need to normalize that being a simp is okay.
Hey.
Hey.
Being a simp is okay. There's nothing wrong with being a simp. I'm a simp for my girlfriend. Are you a simp for your girlfriend?
I'm a huge simp for my girlfriend. The other day, or last time I saw her, I was literally painting her fingernails and toenails.
My girlfriend and I keep talking about how she wants to paint my fingers and toenails. And I do want her to do it. It's just we haven't gotten together for a while to do it. She was over this weekend, but she did not bring the stuff to paint my nails.
She didn't do the thing to do the stuff.
Julie, do the thing. I love Varric. So, I can't hear you again if you're talking.
Hello.
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 Were you saying something? I'm sorry.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, okay. We're talking about being a simp for our girlfriends.
Yes.
Normalize.
It needs to be normalized.
Normalize simp behavior. Let's make a t-shirt that says normalize simp behavior in like a funky cool font with color.
I am all for that idea.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Put it up on the screen. Normalize simp behavior.
Future editing, Dalton. Put it up on the screen.
Put it up on the screen. Put it on the board.
Put it on the board. God, it's been so long since we were in school and I still say that today.
I do too. It's just one.
No one ever knows what I'm talking about, but I still say it.
I say it to people that are like from Velva sometimes, and like Will doesn't know what I'm saying. I'm like, well, you didn't go here, but like Brandon was in Mr. Broughton's class. He should know what I'm talking about.
He should.
Put it on the board.
Put it on the board.
Mr. Broughton really was, like, the radio DJ in the mornings in class, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was.
It's like the guys from Family Guy, Dingo and the Baby.
Yeah.
Stewie and Brian.
It was weird, though, because when we had him as our sixth grade teacher, he was an awesome teacher. But then he turned into a high school teacher, and then he was a shit teacher.
He was a shit teacher. I just think he was less prepared for what teaching high school was. And it was his first year, so I can't be like, oh, he was really, really bad at it. But at the same time, dude, you gotta give your, like, students prep for your tests. You can't just talk about something and then have, like, none of it appear on the test, and everything you didn't talk about is what we're tested on. And people are like, well, you should read the book. It's like, well, A, the homework was never reading the book. B, every time the homework was reading the book, we were fucking stupid teenagers, and we would go through and pick, like, oh, well, the answer says it's here, so I'm going to go to this page and read it, and then that's all I'm going to read.
Go till you find the answer to the questions in the homework assignments, and then call it a day.
Exactly. Because, like, as a high school student, you're really busy. You don't have time to absorb, like, 90% of the information that these teachers are forcing down your throat.
Still don't remember anything that I learned in my science classes, other than the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell.
I remember Newton's first law of gravity, an object in motion.
Okay, yeah.
Like, stuff like that. And, like, 3.14159
92653.
Okay, there we go.
I know that much.
Yep. And, like, most of my school experience was, like, honestly, looking back on it, was defined more by my interactions with the teachers and less by what I actually learned from them. Does that make sense?
I mean, isn't that kind of what high school is?
Well, yeah, exactly. But I don't remember a whole lot of what I learned. Excuse me. I don't remember, like, shit about what I learned from a lot of teachers in, like, the realm of school. But in, like, interactions I had with them and, like, things that they taught me about life, I remember a whole lot more. Which is good. I just wish there was more of that. I wish school was more focused around things like that. Teaching people how to grow and become, you know, functioning members of society, rather than teaching people how to work a 9-to-5 job so that they can become a cog in the corporate machine. You feel me? You ever just think life is useless? I lost you again, I think. Hello?
Hello?
Hi, again.
Hi.
But yeah, corporate machine and all that.
Corporate machine?
Did you hear what I was saying about school?
Them teaching us that about having to work a 9-to-5 job every day and...
Yeah, instead of, like, preparing people to, like, work a 9-to-5 job with, like, basic information to be part of the corporate machine, and, like, that's all you do, you should teach people how to, like, be functioning members of society and, like, pay taxes, and, like, you should teach them valuable life skills rather than just teaching them information.
I do my taxes.
What about your taxes? I'm sorry.
I said I still don't know how to do them.
I know how to do my taxes. I don't.
I pay a guy to do them.
I was about to say, I don't know how to, like, fill the paperwork out myself. I suppose I could read it and find out. But, like, I went through H&R Block and just used their free file option online. And, like, I got it done myself. But they did all the heavy lifting, so to speak. And fun fact, I guess I don't know how to do my taxes. Because today, I called the bank because I checked with the IRS, and the IRS said that my tax return was completed. And it was not. They're like, well, we sent it to your bank on Thursday. If it doesn't appear by Monday the 15th, call your bank. So that's what I did. I called the bank. It turns out that when filing my taxes, I put in, so on my bank account, my name is in all caps. On my IRS tax form, my name is not in all caps. So when the IRS sent the direct deposit to my bank, the bank fucking rejected it. Because my name wasn't spelled out in all caps, and their computer didn't catch it. Are you fucking kidding me? I'm angry about this.
Again, but with all caps, or what?
What did you say? I'm sorry. I just heard again with all caps.
Does that mean... Oh, God. Does that mean you're gonna have to file again, but with all caps in the name?
No, I can go back and correct my taxes with the IRS. What's more than likely gonna happen, though, is that because it's, like, the date that the IRS is like, oh, they rejected your return, time to, like, send it to your physical address, they'll more than likely have
to
send me a
send
check.
Send it to you?
Yeah, send it, Because my physical address is on my taxes. They'll just send me a check.
Yes, that works.
I guess, but I was, I was kind of hope banking on having $1,800 to go get a car. I guess 14 will do. For now.
Fine.
And I guess I can always get some help from Dad and pay him back. It's not the end of the world. We talked about it a little bit. It's just a hassle, man.
It is a hassle.
Tis a hassle. And taxes are so confusing. Why are taxes like a basic need for like the people of the United States? Why is filing taxes by yourself so difficult? Why do they make it so hard on purpose? Can't hear you again. I'm sorry.
No idea.
Oh, I heard no idea.
I've got no idea as to why it's so hard.
It's just weird. Like you'd think, like I said, because literally every person that makes money in the United States has to pay taxes, you'd think that they would make it easier. You wouldn't have to go through like a privatized company like H&R Block or like TurboTax and have these people file your taxes for you. You should just be able to like either go online and do it yourself, like with their free file tool for like really, really easy, or be able to fill out the paperwork really, really easily.
So they can create jobs to actually like fully in depth understand the economic system. Maybe.
I mean, I guess. I feel like it's just to make it easier for them to take people to jail on tax stuff, though. That's my kind of opinion on it. I feel like the reason it's so hard to do taxes is that it makes it easier for the IRS to take money from people. And that might be a really jaded way of looking at it. But,
That
like,
makes our country look really fucked up. I mean,
doesn't
granted,
it though? And
our country is a little is fucked up, but like still.
that's kind of my point by saying that is because like that is really fucked up. We live in a we live in one of the only countries, like the only non-third world and second world countries anymore that don't have some kind of free health care for our citizens. You have to have insurance. And you have to go through a private company to get your insurance. You can't, you can go through the government if you have a low enough income. You can get Medicaid or whatever it is. I think it's Medicaid, not Medicare, Medicaid. Because that's what the card says in my wallet. If you're low enough income, but I think everybody should be able to get something like that. Because, if, like, for instance, you move out, you're working a 9-to-5 job, you bust your back, like you fall down and break one of your lower vertebrae. You're working a 9-to-5 job, you can only pay for your rent and groceries, like barely every month. And now you have to go to the emergency room, likely in an ambulance, which is $5,000 on its own, and pay out of pocket if you don't have insurance, all of the like the medical expenses. That's ridiculous. Over something that you, like, literally, you weren't planning on breaking your back. It just happened to you. I'm sorry, I can't hear you. Your ring's not lighting up on Discord. Well, ing? I heard ing.
As I said, that's because I wasn't saying anything.
Oh, okay. But yeah, isn't that just like a screwed up system?
Yeah, it really is.
When you think about it, because like look at countries like Denmark and Canada. Like, yeah, there's long wait times, but at least people can get health care for free. You know, it's not necessarily the best healthcare, but it's healthcare enough to keep you going. And, like, you'll get real emergency services if you need it. Like, if you have a heart attack, it's not like you're going to be like, oh, sorry, you have to wait 5 hours in the waiting room. Like, no, like, they'll bring you in an ambulance, and they'll do surgery on you or whatever they have to do right away. Hello?
There you are.
Hi. Hello.
I know you went on a spiel for a quick second, but I did not hear any of it.
Oh, I was just saying, look at other countries like Denmark and Canada. Like, obviously, you have, like, there are wait times for things like, oh, if you're sick, or oh, if you're, you really, like, sprained your wrist or something. But, like, if you have a heart attack, if you have a heart attack, or if you have, like, you know, an ambulance service, they're gonna take you to the emergency room, obviously, and you're gonna get treatment. And you might have to pay some out-of-pocket costs, but it's not ridiculous. It's not, like, $9,000 or whatever it is. It's like, oh, it's probably going to be, like, a grand, maybe. You know?
Sent that really high amount of a bill that a family had to pay because a dad had a heart attack?
You have?
Did I send you the meme that I found on it?
Was it a long time ago?
It was a while ago. Here, I'll send it to you right now.
Okay, I was gonna say send it to me because I don't quite remember.
You might want to do some cropping and put it in the video or whatever.
Yeah, I can do that. Give me a sec to look at it. What we got?
Yes, I sent it to you. That is so high.
Yeah. See, my dad was smart. He had a heart attack and his died. His funeral was just $6,000. I miss my dad, though. What the fuck? Yeah, isn't that ridiculous? Like, nobody...
Dad, a week in a hospital because he had a heart attack. And his charges are $131,000.
Isn't that the stupidest bullshit? Isn't that the most stupid... Like, he wasn't, like I said, it's not like he planned to have a heart attack. It's not like he woke up this morning and was like, I'm going to have a heart attack today. I'm going to go to the hospital. Like, no. Like, obviously, you could make the argument of, like, well, maybe he should have taken better care of himself. What if he was old? What if he was, like, 65 years old and he's taking good care of himself, but he's, like, he's a carnivore and he eats lots of meat, you know? Things like that. And, like, it's just stupid how the medical system in our country works sometimes. Because, like, people will go to the hospital for something they really, really need and then get fucked in the ass by the hospital or who, like, and I understand. I understand that they're, like, you have to pay for a doctor's professional services. I get that. But why is
it so much?
Yeah. Why is it so high? Why is it $131,000? Like,
or notice how little effort insurance companies help their claimers?
Oh, absolutely. Fucking absolutely. So, Alyssa at the beginning of the summer got bit by a cat who they thought might have had rabies. And so the doctors at Pinkerton told her, you should probably go get a rabies shot. So Alyssa went and got a rabies shot. She found out, take a guess at how much the rabies shot was. A set of rabies shots. Four shots. They stuck four needles into her stomach and, or no, three needles into her stomach and one into her booty. And guess how much money it was.
Wasn't it like $7,500?
It was $25,000 at the end of it.
God, that is ridiculous.
For them to stick a needle in my girlfriend's arm with medicine in it. It was 25, or excuse me, in her body with medicine in it. It was $25,000. That's fucking ridiculous.
These prices.
I don't know. And like a lot of the argument, you could make the argument of like, oh, it's the pharmaceutical companies. Yeah, I understand that. That's why I think like a privatized medical industry is stupid. I don't think that independent companies should be like the ones, like I'm not saying that they shouldn't be the ones creating medicine, but they definitely shouldn't be the ones distributing the medicine to people who need it. Because then they can just gouge on the price of it. You know, if you have a hospital, you know, new healthcare system. The government now buys medicine for the hospitals. Every single medicine. All right, let's just pretend we have the money for it. Because realistically, we do. We have the money for it. Just slash the defense budget by some. The defense budget is $815 billion or something like that. It's huge. You can slash it by that. We don't need $815 billion running our military. We don't. So take like 35% of that. Make sure that the citizens of the United States, all of the hospitals, you buy medicine for the hospitals. Now, all of that gets taken out of A, the military budget, and B, people's Social Security payments. That's what it's going towards anyways. You know, and so, this new, you know, for, I'm sorry. I lost my train of thought. But yeah. For instance, if the government were to buy all of the hospital's medicine, things like, you know, the hospital wouldn't be dealing with these private companies. The government would. So the government can say, well, hey, we think you're charging too much for this vaccine for the flu. Whatever, you're charging $9,000 for a flu vaccine, a shot of flu vaccine. Like, that's too high. So what we're going to do is we're going to pay for it and then, you know, split the cost somehow between like the government spending, hospital spending, etc., so that the people of the United States can get medical treatment if they need it.
In my opinion, I don't think our military budget needs to be as high anymore.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. We've been
fighting. It's not like we're going to get in a war anytime soon.
No.
So, you know, knock on wood, of course, but you know.
Yeah, knock on wood. But the military budget is $800 billion. What are we using that for? We're not in any wars. People are like, oh, well, we're still over in, like, Syria and Iran. It's like, well, we're not doing anything over there. We're killing innocent people. We're over there so we can take over natural resources and shit like that and use this fear-mongering tactic of the war on terrorism to take people's resources. It's stupid.
The students of North... Students, I mean, like, as in us college students, students our age, just recently went to Washington, D.C. to for the education system for $2 billion. Just two! To put that money into our education system.
Isn't that the stupidest? Isn't that the stupidest that we have... That students... Students, the people that are experiencing the education system, have to be the ones to beg the government to make it better. Isn't that the most stupid shit? You'd think that the colleges and the institutions themselves would be, hey, government, we need you to make things better. We need you to give us more money. But no, all the colleges really care about is that we're paying tuition. They don't care about our education. You know?
I mean, don't.
No, they really, really don't. You know, all they care is that they get their money from us, and really, they're not even getting their money from us. They're getting their money from the government. They're fully backed, so it's not like they're out anything. So they really don't give a shit.
Gosh, if you're looking outside, like, I don't mean like, God, what am I trying to say? If you're an outside party listening to this conversation, it totally sounds like we hate America.
I hate America.
I mean, I do to an extent.
I...
But also, as I have been into a bunch of other countries, and people say we are not a third world country, I definitely would say we're like a... Not a third world, but a second world country.
Isn't that the weirdest... Like, America has been, like, this global superpower. We've preceded this image of, like, this really, really tough country for so long. But we don't even take care of our people. All we care about is our image.
Unless a crap ton of other countries that are... People would say are not doing financially better, quote-unquote. But that's also because the way they distributed those funds, that makes the quality of life better. So, yes, they're not... financially better, but you know, they're living life a lot better than we are.
Yeah, and like, I hate the grind culture of the United States. This idea that we have to wake up and work every day to make as much money as we can to be successful in life. That's stupid. That's so asinine. It really, really is. Because all you're doing is you're making money for other people when you do that. You're making money for yourself, don't get me wrong. But when you're working, like, every single job, when you work every single job, all you're doing is providing your time and labor to other people so that they can make money. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. But if you're doing that, if you're providing your time and labor for other people to be making money, they should be able to pay you a living wage. You should be able to live off of a full-time job. One full-time job.
Is the emphasized word in this situation.
What's that?
I said should is the emphasized word in this
situation. Should is the emphasized word in this situation. Nobody that is working a full-time job should be struggling to pay bills every month. Now, I'm not saying that they need to thrive. You know, somebody working a full-time job doesn't need to be making $30 an hour unless they're, like, a skilled position. You know, if I'm flipping burgers at McDonald's, like, yeah. Like, just pay me a fair minimum wage. Like, I understand that, like, inflation is, like, a bitch. Inflation is stupid. But also, look at countries like Denmark. Denmark, fast food employees in Denmark can make up to $27 an hour, like, starting. Isn't that crazy?
That is so high.
Isn't it? And that's like...
But they're able to easily supply that.
Yeah, it's a living wage. And here's the kicker. A lot of the times, it's not that the businesses aren't able to supply a living wage. It's that they're not. You know, this is like the most old argument ever, but look at Amazon. Amazon pays their workers $15 an hour. Yes, that is it's an argument point, I guess. But here's the kicker. They can't unionize. You can't form a union if you work for Amazon. You can't be part of the union. When you're training in at Amazon, they show you videos and you have to read material that is specifically anti-union. You basically have no rights if you work at Amazon. You know, the conditions are dangerous, the pay is subpar for the job you're doing. And look at Amazon. Amazon is a 180-something billion-dollar company. Or at least Jeff Bezos, the guy who owns Amazon, is worth $180 billion, something like that. Why can't you pay your workers, like, a good wage for the shitty, hard work they're doing? $15 an hour is not a good wage for that kind of work.
If you as a person are worth over $180 billion, why? Why do you need so much money?
Exactly. I keep saying here's the kicker, but here's the real kicker on the billionaire thing. I know this is like baby's first talk about billionaires, but nobody gets to be a billionaire off of their own hard work. Not a single person. It's impossible. You could work a like every day for the rest of your life and never make $1 billion. The only reason people have $1 billion is because they're profiting off of other people's work. It's because they're profiting off of the work that other people do for them. And if you're profiting that much off of the work that people for you do, you should be paying these people a more than livable wage. You should be paying these people enough to thrive, to have like a nice house, a nice car. You know?
Figure out what else to talk about now.
What's that? I heard figure out what else to talk about now.
I said I'm trying to figure out what else to bring up now.
Well, on that heavy note, we could just call it a night.
I mean, that works for me too.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't very St. Paddy's Day like, but it's the return. We're back.
It is
baby.
The return.
We're back. Surprise, motherfuckers. You thought we were gone, didn't you?
Nope, we're not.
Guess who's back? Back again. Guess who's back? Tell a friend. But I had an immensely fun time talking to you tonight, Tyler, even with the technical difficulties.
Hopefully that won't be a bunch of a problem.
Yeah.
Later
on this year, tentative plans are I'll be getting an apartment with my girlfriend here as soon as I can get myself a car and get everything set up to get some rent scratched together. And then we'll be getting good, solid, really good internet in the apartment. That's like my one mission statement for the apartment is it needs good internet. I don't care if I have nice furniture. I just want good internet. But on that note, this has been Sellout Club number, I haven't looked in a while. Shit.
I have no idea.
Sellout Club number something. Number something. Whatever it is. It's been the St. Patrick's Day special. My name is Dalton.
I am Tyler.
And we will talk to you next time. And remember,
Wash
your hands.
Yeah, bringing it back.
Bringing it back.